Hello and welcome, my friend. And then I am planning to show you that how to repair this broken trailer light. And now I have really situation that all of these my trailer lights are off, even that I have lights in my car. And let's go to look what I mean. Okay, and now there is really situation that I have lights in my car, but in my trailer there is no any lights. And what is now issue? Let's go to look. Okay, and then the most common issue area is this cable, this trailer electric cable, and especially that connector in here, in this one. And normally we have most of these issues inside in that connector, and let's go to open and we can find that why there is no any electricity inside in this my cable. Okay, and now I need for that opening Phillips head screwdriver, and there is two screws, and let's go to look inside that why there is no any electricity in my trailer. Okay. Okay, and now I continue. And there is two screws. Okay, now they are open, and then I open this cover, and then when we look in this inner area, there is rule that all of these cables must go in these cables, what are different colors, they must go in one of these point, and there is flathead screw what keeps these cables in position. Okay, and now we are so lucky that when I have this flathead screwdriver, I can right away see that one of these cables is really cut. And this is the most common issues that this my cables are cut, and this is especially this is minus cable, and that's all of these my another lights like parking light, flasher, and then these side and fog lights, they are not working because this is very critical minus cable. Okay, and what I need to do next? I need to next cut all of these cables, and I will also install this new cover in here. And let's look at what happens next. Okay, and then when I am planning to install new connector in here, like in that one, there is idea that I need to cut these cables. This is like in example case, I need these pliers, and now I cut all of these cables in that way and also in that one. And then I know exactly that in what position these my cables goes in this my new connector, because there is those number codes in here. We can see those numbers, and all of these cables, they must go directly in same position. Okay, and there is this my example, and then I open this my new connector in that way, and I open these screws. Okay, and there is also Phillips head screws. I need to open both of those screws totally. Okay, and now they are open, and I can open this in that way. And then when I have this my connector, now I have to connect these all cables in same way back. And there is thing that there is this locking plate, and I need to open also that one, and this keeps this my cable in in tight, and this is like safety thing. Now it's ready. Then I install this cable back in that way, and in that slot I install my cable. And then when I have these cables, now I need to little bit open this my area, and next I need knife. Okay, and here is my knife, and now I little bit open this black outer cable and carefully in that way, and then I can move this cable a little bit far away. And there is a rule that this cable must be in that position, and then this connector comes in here in just one position in here, in that way. And it is good to remember that there are those metallic holes, that this part, this goes only in one way in there, when I rotate that. This is trick also. And now it's in position, good. And then I can also install this cover back, and this is the position. And now I check that if this goes in like in here, and then this cable goes in here, and I have to let this black area in this point, because I tied this my cable in here. And okay, this is good. And then I have to open these cables, this copper area in here, and for that purpose, if we have these pliers and these cutters, like in this one, what is made in USA, this works so excellent that I choose these numbers, and firstly this biggest one, and I need to take only this rubber blue cover away, and this is too big, and then I change smaller one, and then I press this in here, and I pull out this cable, and it is almost ready, and I take even little bit smaller, and again I pull out, and now this part is ready, and then I can rotate that little bit in that way, and then this area is ready for connecting in this area. And now I need also soon flathead screwdriver, and then I do same thing in this next one, next cable in here. Now it's ready, and then next one. And there is really idea that I have to install these cables in just in same position back. Okay. Now this one is ready, and then this green one. Good. And then red one. Red one. Okay, now I missed that. I have to do that again. Okay, now it's good. Then yellow one in here. Now yellow one is there, and then white one. Okay, now I have all of these my cables, and then I need to only check that what is number of here, and then I connect in here. And now I need my flathead screwdriver also. Okay, now I have flathead screwdriver. And this purpose is that now when I open these cables, connectors, I need to install this my flathead screwdriver in here, and I need to open this screw totally, that there is hole, look. Now it's like open, and then next one, now it's closed, But then when I install my flathead screwdriver and I rotate, I open that. Good. And then next one. And then also this inner area. And it is firstly good to open all of these in that way. And then this one. And then that one. And this is final one. Okay, and then I start this my job that firstly I install this minus cable, and there are numbers 2 and 5, 4. Okay. And then I search in here this 2 in that side area. There is 2. There are numbers, but they are a little bit difficult to see. Okay, and I search those a little bit. Okay, and now I have found in here there is letter like 4 and R in here, and in that area there is 4 and R letter, and it is green cable in here, and in 4 and R I need to install now this green cable, and there is this green cable. Firstly I make this more solid, this green cable, and it is 4, that one, 4 and R, and I install this cable in here, in that way, and then I take my flathead screwdriver, this is, there is 4 and R in that one. In here, in that way, good. And then it is important that I install only this copper part in this area. And this rubber part, it must be away in this copper area. And that means that this is my part, and in this way. And then I rotate this nut, and soon this my cable is tight. Okay, and it is easy to check that if this, now it was loosened. Okay, and that's I have to do that again. This was too loosened. Good to test. Again in there, that way, and again I fasten, okay, good, okay, and now this cable is ready, and then I will install all of these cables in same way, like in here, and then there is interesting thing that this one, this central part, it is like brown. Let's see that what is brown in here. It is this one. And now I install also this, like an example. Firstly I do nice connection in here, and then in this central area. In here, and carefully, that this rubber must be in away, and then rotation. And then good connection. And then I check that this is solid connection. And look, that now this rubber is only in this top level area, not in inside. And then I can install also, when we check that what is this, there is three and then three. And let's look that what is this three and three. And this is like white cable. And now I need to install in here this white cable and again rotation and three in here in that way. And then in this is right area, white is only in this top level, and then I fasten that and carefully, then well final togue, and then I check that cable is okay, good. And now I have connect three of these cables and I have left four. And next I will connect these also and then we can continue. Okay, and now I am almost ready. I am installing this last one for this red cable. And red cable is like this 4546 is this number code. And now it is tight. And now I have installed, or actually there is one cable left. And it must go in, it is black one, black cable. And black cable's place is this final one. It goes in here, and then screw tight. Okay, and then I need to check that all of these cables are in good connection, that they are not loosened, and everything looks good, excellent. And then my next step is to take this my plastic cover, this metallic cover, and install this tight protector. This is like pull protector. And I install first it happens so that I rotate that carefully and then this my connector goes in there deeper. To rotate that so much that it goes nicely, not in yet, and this part it must go in this slot. And this takes little bit time, and there are those dents, and these dents, and I little bit adjust this my cable, because this is not so easy, but soon I will show that how it should be in there. Okay, and now I managed to install this in position, and there is really idea that in one position this connector goes in deeper of these metallic holes in here. And it is easy to know that when we rotate that, and now it's deeper, and then I have to install this part, because this is really critical, because this is like safety equipment. This eliminates this pull force, and now I install these two screws and Phillips head screwdriver. And this is really important that this black outer rubber is in below and inside of that area, and these cables are lie free. Because otherwise, if we pull out this our cable, these connectors opens and they are loosened, and then we lost this our electricity. Okay, good. Okay, and then second screw. Okay, and then that one. Both must be tight, and then final step is to pull this our cable, and it must be in solid, no any movement in here. And this is excellent. Now I have connected this, and then final step is to install this outer cover, and then this part must go in that way. That if these lines are together, our connection is ready and in here. But if there is any hole in here, then we have made mistake. And now I close this outer cover in that way, and second. In this way, good. Okay, and then there is one, this dust boot in here, and it goes in that area. It's like dust boot. Cool, now it's nicely. And then we go to test that how this my connector works. Okay, and then I connected this my cable in my car's connector, and cables looks good, and then we go to look this my trailers like that, how they are working now. Okay, and now when we look my trailer lights, it looks good, and now I take light away, we can see that lights are working, and then I need to also check flashers, how they works. Okay, and flashers works also, and I am very happy because now this repair is ready, and my friend thumbs up, and this was this idea that how to repair broken and dead trailer lights. And please be happy, and a good day to you, my friend.